Well, Mose, Carissa, can you tell me where this all began?
I met Chris in 2011 in Mona Vale, and yeah, it's all started from there.
Romantic setting?
Yeah, Mona pub.
What was your memory of that time when you met him?
We sort of just met and we got on really well, and basically I'm pretty sure from the week we met, we haven't really been apart since.
On January 12, 2020, Mose Masoe's life changed forever when an innocuous tackle in a pre-season friendly resulted in a career-ending spinal injury. Back to that moment, that day on the field, the pre-season friendly, what was going through your head when you lay on the field?
I just knew at the time that it was bad, just because I couldn't feel anything, and that's when I knew it was quite bad. And as soon as the doctor ran on the field, I kind of said to her, I think I broke my neck.
Were you at the game?
Yeah, I was there.
Did you know what was going on?
I just heard it went really quiet, and I sort of looked up and I noticed a few people looking at me. And then I looked up, I thought, where's Ten? Looked over and I could see, you could tell from the way he was laying at first that he wasn't okay. And I sort of sat there for a moment. He was still in the field, and then I left the girls with some of the other partners and went down, waited for him in the change room. And yeah, the moment he came in, he knew it wasn't good.
Yeah, I got Chris to like, to pinch my leg really.
Yeah.
And I was like, pinch my leg. And then 10 seconds later, I was like, did you pinch my leg? And she was like, yeah. And then it had like big.
Like, he had like dents in his skin from how hard I was pinching.
What was going through your head at that time?
I'd come out into the waiting room and I'd see, you know, that some of the coaching staff, and they'd be in tears after we'd found out. And I think we both were like, okay, if we sort of give in right now, then we're not really going to get anywhere.
Were you told you'd never walk again?
The doctors always give you like a chance, like chances, but they said it was very unlikely that you would walk again. You'd, you know, hopefully get in a wheelchair, but. You know, I wasn't taking that.
That motivated you
even more? It was a challenge, yeah. They kind of set the challenge for myself, and I didn't want that to be me.
Is that the sort of person he is? Sees the positive side to things?
Yes, always. Yeah.
So what did the support of the rugby league fraternity mean to you last year?
Oh, it's been amazing. I just want to thank everyone in England and everyone here in Australia and New Zealand. Like, it's been amazing. I think without their support, we don't know where we'll be.
Definitely.
Yeah, definitely.
So the Sports Bets Try July campaign, what did that do for the family?
Oh, that was massive. We can't thank Sports Bet and Men of League for teeing that up for us. We enjoyed it just as much as, you know, the viewers, you know, watching all the boys do the Try July celebrations. It was pretty cool to watch. All the boys supporting myself and the family, so I can't thank them enough. If it wasn't for the help of the rugby league community, we don't know where we would be.
Yeah.
Just want to say thank you.
I see you're emotional now.
It's always emotional when people care about you.
What about this house you're going to build, and how will that change your lives?
We've put most of the money that's been raised towards our house somewhere where Mose can get around the house safely. It's massive.
Last year, the Sportsbet Try July campaign raised over $250,000 for their dream home. Can you talk us through it?
We've gone for a design where there's a bedroom and a bathroom downstairs.
I think after the build is done, we'll probably maybe go down and put a stair lift in as well.
What can Try July mean to somebody else in the future?
Oh, it can mean everything. This has helped us, you know, put money towards a house, and you know, I'm really grateful and really honoured to announce that Try July for 2022 is going ahead. It's going to two great causes, the Red Cross Australia, and half of the money is going to the people affected in the floods, and half of the money is going to the recovery in Tonga. So I'm really looking forward to Try July this year, because, you know, if the boys come out and do the same thing and more, it can make people's dreams come true.